Huh. I guess the Fellowship really couldn't take the Eagles to Mordor.
Hello everyone and welcome. Today, in honor of the new Lord of the Rings, the Rings of Power show, please be good, we answer the question, can you beat Elden Ring as the Witch King of Angmar?
We pick Vagabond for the base 13 dexterity, then I do my best to recreate the Witch King, which was actually pretty difficult because the only references I had were old man and really old man. I guess it ultimately doesn't matter because we're going to be wearing armor for once, but with that, we're off.
So first, I'd like to explain a little something about this run. As it is a themed run, it makes sense that anything that fits thematically I could use, and the Witch King of Angmar was once a man, based on this photo, I'm not really sure which one he is, but they all used a sword. In fact, even after turning into a ring wraith, he still uses a sword. I mean, he stabs Frodo with a Morgul blade, which is admittedly a special spooky magical sword, but a sword nonetheless. However, I know none of you came here to see me beat this game with something as easy as a plain as day normal sword, so I've decided to go with the flail weapon class exclusively. What could possibly go wrong? Unfortunately, there is no great flail in this game, so my options were either the Knight Rider flail or the Chainlink flail. Personally, I feel like the Chainlink flail looks more like the one the Witch King used, so that's the one I'm going for.
We grab Baby's first flail to do my favorite part of every run. Spending 2 hours running around the whole map picking things up off the ground.
On our way to Weeping Peninsula, we gotta be careful of the ballista because it... Well, that's just unfortunate. And so it was that this one soldier of Godric saved Middle-earth. Men might have succumbed to the power of the One Ring, but Melina here succumbs to the power of our chiseled abs and invites us back to her place. Well now, that's a mighty fine helmet you got there. Be a shame if someone took it. So some of you might know that the regular flail has a dex requirement of 18, but fret not, dear viewer, through my amazing mass skills of 13 plus 5, I know that with Radagon Sword Seal we have enough to wield it. Which is good, because the Chainlink flail only jumps from the pumpkinhead enemies that use it, and I'm sure glad we're doing normal damage to him. This farm wasn't actually so bad. I found a way to pretty consistently kill the pumpkinhead before he could even retaliate, so... yeah? Anyone looking to farm the pumpkinhead enemy with the regular flail at base stats, here you go. Eventually, the new flail drops, and spoiler alert, it really isn't much of an upgrade, but for now, I think it's time we find some pants. All of the armor I want to use is super late game because of course it is, so for now, I think we go with a juvenile scholar set because... I don't know, they look roby, I guess? This run has a lot of early game conflicts and compromises, okay? I might be a Nazgul, but I am not an uncultured swine. The first boss up is Royal Knight Loretta, so now might be the best time to talk about the flail weapon class. They're not good. The damage is mediocre, and the moveset is... fine? But the speed at which you swing the flail is pretty slow, which means that the passive bleed buildup isn't gonna save you like it would if you were using a katana or daggers, or literally anything else. Not that it really matters for Loretta, cause she's, you know, frickin' ghost. The poise damage is actually acceptable, so surprise, jumping strong attacks are the way to go, but overall just not a good weapon class, unfortunately. They might be better when used with a shield for guard breaks or power stance, but I don't recall seeing the Witch King do that, so I won't either. And so it was that Royal Knight Loretta saved Middle-earth. Eventually, Loretta goes down and we try to befriend skeletons in the graveyard.
I don't think they like me very much.
Hello, kind sir. I heard you had some clothes for me. Now, I'm worried they're gonna be the wrong size. What's your return policy?
Oh. Okay, I guess all sales are final.
Yep, this is 100% what an Nazgul looks like. Don't you look it up. Don't you dare Google what does an Nazgul look like, then come back here and comment. Don't you do it. Whatever. Next, we head to the Rhea Lucaria Crystal Tunnel, and did you know that there's a spirit spring here? I've been jumping down the gravestones like an idiot. And so it was that fucking gravity saved Middle-earth. Blue Daba soon to be dead here is what you would call a non-issue, and with him out of the way, we can easily upgrade our flail and pay a visit to Fia. You know, this game has a lot of waifus, but Fia is the only one that actually holds you, so... I'm trying to progress her questline, but honestly, I wanted the health debuff because at this point, I thought flails weren't that bad.
And I won't regret that one.
Now, it's finally time to take on the first real boss of the run, Margit. Like always, I have way too many heals for this, so it's more of a chance to just test out the weapon on a normal boss, and let me tell you, this thing fail. That's what the F in flail stands for. Fail. Flail. Yep, that's the A+ content you all came here for. Margit isn't a problem, but this is about the point when I realized what I was in for. I mean, spinning chain is the fastest move in our kit, and it still takes forever to proc bleed. I would honestly rather do this with a singular ordinary dagger.
Anyway, he dies, and like 90% of the bosses in this game, he continues the monologue even after defeat. How is this? What even is... Do these bosses just have like a pocket Dead Man Switch tape recorder? Or, I don't understand. And now it is time for me to do my best impression of a fan. Even the enemies hate the dogs in FromSoft games. So this will come as an absolute shock to none of you, but Godric is extremely easy. Even with a weapon as bad as a flail, the only way to make him legitimately difficult would be to superglue thumbtacks to my controller's buttons. We even get a guard break on him, which in most cases is the only time we can actually utilize spinning chain, so that's neat. I did get grabbed near the end of the fight due to big brain micro spacing plays, but apparently these robes are made out of actual water because that damage is pathetic. After he goes down, we make our way to Hogwarts to prove which franchise is superior. Spoiler alert, it's absolutely Lord of the Rings. Man, they did not like that fact. Whoa, Fido, calm down now. We're just playing. Easy, easy. God, I just noticed I look more like a disgruntled long-haired Colonel Sanders than I do the Witch King. What can I say? I'm a fan of Rennala. I don't care if I already made that joke. That's pure gold right there. So yeah, phase 1, not a problem. And phase 2 shouldn't be a problem, but I'm bad, so. Next attempt, Rennala bows to us and takes our spiky stick to the face. I'm sorry, Fia. Rennala meant nothing to me. Please forgive me. I'll do anything. Hey, you want this totally normal and innocuous dagger? Surely nothing bad will happen at all. I promise. Man, guess that dagger turned out to be a real thorn in his side. Yeah, it'd leave me too. I need to start Ronnie's questline to finish Fia, so it's off to the Caria Manor. Do you think if you were dating Ronnie and gave her the pet name Doll that she'd be mad? I mean, it's like dating a normal person and affectionately calling them human, so I don't know. At any rate, we need to get into Nokron, so I head over to fight Rodan. Here I learned that the strong attack on the horse is actually a multi-hit attack. Still sucks, but that's cool, I guess. Anyone else notice how the boss attacks in this game are either fighting game levels of combos or cutscenes with damage attached to them? I'm making a joke, but a lot of attacks are really, really just enjoyable to watch. Anyway, after a few more bonks, Rodan goes down.
Who are you?
I'm you, but more stupider.
Ah, impressive. So y'all want to see something actually stupid? Yeah. So, maybe there is a very niche use for the flail, but this would never work on a real person. I hope. The whole reason we came here was for the Finger Slayer blade, and after we get it, we return to Ronnie, where she gives us the upside down wood carving, which is the best trade deal in the history of trade deals possibly ever. I hate this game. And yes, for those wondering, this is 100% an omen for what's to come. At the top of the tower, we find Ronnie's real body with the same complexion I have after spending more than 5 minutes in the sun, also the curse mark of death. Making our way back to Nokron, it's time for the second worst duo boss fight in FromSoft history, the Bell Gargoyles on steroids.
Duo fights are not FromSoft's strong suit. I don't know why they keep trying to make this work. It has not worked since Ornstein and Smough 11 frickin' years ago.
Eventually we beat the Gargoyles. Not before they give me one final heart attack though, but it's fine. Having a high heart rate is the same as exercise, right? So can anyone tell me why Godwin the Golden is part fish? I mean, surely there must be lore on this, right? Maybe it's the way he's sitting. No, that's a mermaid tail. Whatever, I'm not here to question art design, I'm here to beat up Fia's champions. I wonder if spin to win works. Yes. The answer is yes. It works on both of the first two, but unfortunately the third fight is a gank squad, so we had to resort to the old whack 'em until they fall over tactic. Barbaric, but effective. Holy crap, this one apparently dumped everything into Int. That was only 352 damage and was like half your health bar, bro. You gotta level Vigor. Fia, my favorite deathbed companion. I came all this way just for a hug. This is nice. I like this, Fia. Oh, I forgot. I have something for you. The curse mark of death you were looking for. I'm glad you like it. So I was thinking maybe sometime we could go, like, get a smoothie or... Oh. Well, it would seem I have misread the situation. Alright, Lich Dragon 4 to Sex, you are one cool dragon boss, but like half my comments want me to fight you, so prepare to die. Tis but a scratch. Wait, do I have to sit through that long, awkward animation every time I die?
Oh, that isn't annoying at all. Okay, I'll just have to do better this time.
Okay, I'm gonna go become stronger. I will be right back, you big angry dragon.
We can actually skip past the Draconic Tree Sentinel because of the teleporter, so that's neat, I guess.
Okay, just gonna run past this guy and hope nobody jumps out at me? Dude, I was struck by lightning and you still missed.
I already fought two gargoyles. I don't need to fight another one.
Oh, of course it knocks me off. Of course.
Wait a minute. Is that the thing I landed on?
Oh yeah, that definitely didn't feel good.
Gandalf? When did you become golden?
And so jacked.
I don't know what's in the old Toby nowadays, but it must straight up be steroids. Godfrey here is a non-issue. I mean, we can't bleed ghosts, but apparently we can hit them, so eventually he goes down.
Morgott, on the other hand, can be bled. If he would sit still.
There isn't a lot to say about this fight. I mean, there were some interesting hitboxes. He would whiff a swing after a heavy attack, but that's no reason to use the flail over, like, any other weapon.
I tried to proc bleed while he was summoning his swords. It wasn't a good idea.
Oh well, nothing left to say. Just gotta fan his tail a bit. Guess he prefers central cooling.
We head north to the mountaintops exclusively to pick up the next smithing stone bell bearing, then upgrade our flail to a plus 18.
Oh, Fortisax, I'm back!
Well, that doesn't feel like much more damage. Fortunately, it was apparently a skill issue because we win on this attempt. With that, we can get the Mending Rune of the Death Prince, but, more importantly, we can finally pick up Viaset.
Oh yeah, now we're looking like a Nazgul. Or should I say, a Schnazgul?
Please don't leave me.
So we're actually gonna pretty much immediately change this armor, but at least now I feel like we look the part.
Back in Liurnia, we talked to Albus.
Wait a minute.
Nazguls don't listen to requests.
Wow, I don't feel bad at all for that.
Up north, we spend some time tenderizing Commander Nile, then head into the consecrated snowfield. We're here to fight the Knights Cavalry, but I'm not good at fighting them together, so I won't. I use my superior intellect to lure one over to the cliff, and eventually it falls off. I was hoping it would kill him, but keeping them separate is good enough. After one goes down, I think it's a good idea to clear out the random enemies so they don't interfere.
Okay, round two. This time, instead of trying to clear out the enemies, we just pull the other knight's cavalry away and abuse his dumb AI until he dies, giving us his armor. And I finally feel like the true Witch King of Angmar. Except this isn't even my final form. There's still one other piece of armor, but that will come a little later. For now, we head back to the mountaintops to take on the Fire Giant.
Yep, that's about how the fight went.
Okay, so it wasn't as bad as it could have been. I mean, Fire Giant have big health bar, but Bleed Weapon go brr, so...
I guess I can say that this is where I really noticed how bad the bleed buildup actually is on this weapon. I think I only managed to bleed him 3 times, even with the spinning chain attack.
Oh well, in the end, we jump attack him right where the sun don't shine.
Do you get it?
Cause we're a Nazgul and they don't like the sun?
Do you get it?
Mount Doom sure be looking different these days.
I'm being informed that this is in fact not Mount Doom, but instead Mount Doom Koi. Apparently one of the interns thought if they built a second mountain, it would trick the Fellowship into going into the wrong place. We promptly threw him into Mount Doom Koi.
What in the... How did I wake up here?
Man, those barkeeps at the end of the Prancing Pony really know how to mix a drink.
Would you be surprised if I told you I hate this fight?
Because you shouldn't.
There is no joke here. I hate this fight. I'm aware that I am fighting this boss in a way that makes them more difficult than it should be, but I still believe that this boss is just poorly designed. Many of you have commented saying it isn't so bad if you use the tools the game gives you, to which I must retort, hi, you must be new here. I do increasingly stupid and difficult challenge runs for pain.
In all seriousness, I just don't like this boss because it doesn't feel like one boss fight, it feels like two bosses shoved into the same room.
They do have that duo AI where if one is attacking, the other one will occasionally decide not to attack. Occasionally. But aside from that, there's just zero synergy when fighting them.
I don't know about everybody else, but I always just focus one down and completely ignore the other one, but even that is difficult to do because neither of them are ever in a hurry to approach you.
It's so on the nose that From tried to recreate ONS from Dark Souls 1 with this fight that it's just painful to look at.
Similar to that fight, you're supposed to use the pillars to separate them, but the aforementioned problem of both bosses moving slower than molasses kinda makes that a right pain in the ass.
The godskinned fireballs can and will fly over the broken pillars, then there's...
whatever this bullshit is.
How are you gonna look me in the eye and say that that was a fair interaction?
You can't, because it's not. I'm aware that my salt comes from self-imposed challenges, but this fight just isn't designed well. Anyway, I keep getting close, but I can't finish them off, so I head over to the Weeping Peninsula for the Crimson Burst here, the Lux Runes for the Ritual Sword Talisman, and the Halley Tree for the Dragon Crest Great Shield Talisman. I could have also removed the health debuff, but nah, Fia deserves it. After all of our upgrades, it only takes a couple more tries until the Godskin duo bow before the might of Sauron. Up next is my favorite warg man, Malekith, who is absolutely not a problem at all, and I should not be scared of him. Okay, he is a little bit of a problem, but I am still not scared of him. Second try, warg man, let's go! No one saw that, my expert speedrunning skills kicked in to hide my shame and embarrassment, so therefore it does not exist. Second try version 2.0 goes much better, with us standing victorious over the Black Blade. With the Rune of Death unbound, it is time to finally complete the Witch King look. Hey Gideon, I just wanted to apologize for my dagger only video. I really took you by surprise. This time, you should absolutely see this attack coming. So I'm gonna leave this fight uncut, because it's kind of stupid. Listen, I'm not trying to say the flail has a niche use fighting NPCs, because I don't think a lot of people struggle with those, but it kind of does. Like, this wasn't just a one-off fight. Using Spinning Chain is a consistent strategy against every NPC I have fought. Whatever, he dies and we can finally complete the Witch King look. Bit sad it's not a darker gray or black, but it's fine. Now to go show off our new looks to the greatest Chad in the whole game, Godfrey the First Elden Lord. From, if you're so fond of putting two bosses into the same room, give me Godfrey duo. I would be so down to fight two of him at the same time. Phase 1 goes off without anything remarkable happening. He actually never even went into his big explosion phase, and I mean, okay. Looks like meat's back on the menu, boys. Horaloo is a terrifying enemy, but I am part Wraith and he struggles to hit me. And eventually, he goes down. I have come for the One Ring. I am told you have it, tall, red-headed Frodo. Radagon isn't an issue. He can't be bled, but to be honest, I've probably only bled like 4 bosses in this whole run anyway, so at this point I'm not even thinking about it. He goes down and out pops everyone's favorite Flintstone gummy reject, the Elden Beast.
Nothing happens. He dies.
Are you surprised? Because I'm not. This is an easy fight.
As the Dark Army of Sauron has prevailed, he names me Ruler of the Lands Between, and with that, we have beaten Elden Ring as the Witch King of Angmar. Except, I hear tales of those who would stand against his might, so here I am once again, sent into the realm of man to end them.
Melania Blade of Mikula is up first, and wouldn't you know it, she is so easy that we no-hit her phase 1. At this point, I'm starting to think Melania is afraid of me because every time we meet, she goes down without an issue. My next target is Mog, the Lord of Being way scarier than he actually is. The Lord of Blood over here is actually extremely weak to bleed, which sounds like a good thing, except as I have expressed multiple times throughout this run, kinda hard to bleed anything with this weapon. The one time I have to realistically build it up is during his knee heal attack, which to the flail's credit, it does go off, but his health bar is kind of doing the opposite of decreasing. One could say it is even increasing by like a lot. Eventually though, he succumbed to the will of Sauron as well, and that means next up is everyone's favorite snake boy, Rykard. So dear viewer, I am sure you were expecting something along the lines of, I tried, phase 1 is doable, phase 2 sucks, is gimmick boss, serpent hunter spear, torch, dagger, flail. And that was kind of the original plan. I always try Rykard with whatever weapon, but since he's a gimmick boss, I don't mind letting him have a pass. But this time it was a little different. Through a combination of bleed and then this weird block then guard counter the air thing, in my first attempt, I was actually able to bring him down to very low health in phase 2. Unfortunately, I had the wrong tier on, but if I had remembered to put the Crimson Burst back on for passive healing, he would have gone down. So I knew that Rykard could indeed be beaten by flails only, and after about 5 more attempts, he was. So for those of you that complain it doesn't count when I kill him with the spear,
are you not entertained?
Speaking of not being entertained, some of you wonder why I never do Dragonlord Placidus Axe. The real reason is because my runs are always geared towards finishing the game and then Shardbearers as a bonus. That's also why you don't see Estelle, the Regal Ancestor Spirit, or Fortis Axe. But the other reason is that Placidus Axe is kind of a boring fight. Whoa, before you type that angry comment, let me explain. The presentation of this boss, his arena, his design, the music, all of that is top tier, A+. It is a spectacle. But he kind of suffers from the same thing Elden Beast does, where he's a big slow target.
Yes, he has very cool teleportation attacks, but as long as you see the cloud, it's very easy to react to. His most dangerous attack is the I'm a fire in my laser move, which I can admit I died to a couple times, but other than that, he's not that big a threat. I already know some of you will say, well, look at the size of your health bar, of course he isn't an issue, and my response is just, you not leveling Vigor sounds like a you problem. I'm sorry, but there are a billion ways to play this game. I can't be faulted for having health. After just 3 attempts, he goes down. Since we've come this far, we might as well round out the remaining remembrances.
What are you doing in my swamp?
Yes, I 100% aggroed the boss just to make this joke. You know, if I had a nickel for every time I got into a coffin in this game, I'd have 2 nickels, which isn't a lot, but it's weird that it's happened twice.
Come here, you overgrown space scorpion, I wanna show you what we do to the bugs in Middle Earth.
Ha, running away, I see. I too would cower in fear at the might of the Witch King. Uh-oh. That DBZ moment would have been more epic if he did more than like a sixth of my health. Last on the remembrance list is the Regal Ancestor Spirit, and honestly, this one is more of an interactive cutscene than it is a boss fight. I mean, yeah, I'm overleveled for this fight, but he has like, what, 5 attacks and none of them are that threatening? I honestly just kind of feel bad, but with him down, Sauron now holds complete control over the lands between. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching, and if you made it this far, please consider giving a like and subscribing, it helps me out way more than you know, and an extra special thanks to my patrons, stay beautiful y'all. So this run was a bit of a mixed bag. I do not like the flail, it is slow, has not stellar damage, and the bleed buildup is kinda worthless because of the speed. It might be better to power stance them, but I'm not sure how much that would help except with extra poise damage. Overall, it's a neat weapon in concept, but it needs a few changes to make it any good. I hope we get a great flail at some point though, that would be amazing. Also, I want to know what everyone's thoughts are on doing all remembrances is. Originally, I only had Shardbearers and tossed around the idea of thematically appropriate bosses, but many people commented wanting the other remembrances, so now that I have, what do y'all think? I will grant you that they weren't on screen a lot because I made a decision to do them way late in the recording, literally after Elden Beast, so I was comically overpowered for them, but hey, at least they got their little spotlight. Anyway, until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.